Let's start with the top cover. It has clearly been made with love, almost passion in my case, as we admire the fine detailed handwork at the back. This skillfully distributed glue mess makes, however, the tray completely watertight, and a good candidate for reuse to collect any dripping fluids. In a garage as an oil-changing tray for a racing lawnmower, for instance, or during an inopportune baby delivery of a 16 years old. We also have several water pipes. We have the inlet pipe or fill hose. The soap dispenser draw to tub pipe or dispenser hose. The tub to pump drain pipe or sump hose. The drain pipe or drainage hose. I am sure you can do a lot with those, especially if you are into water and into hose. Including some obscure plumbing projects that would excite the Mario Bros, a gobbler shaker call that can attract turkeys or your Aunt Rose, and some lethal sex toys to send over to all your foes. Nothing really useful here. Plastic, 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 plastic. But good to note that the outer tub of this washing machine is part plastic, part calcium carbonate. And as we all know, calcium carbonate being a chemical compound commonly found in calcite and aragonite, this technically does not make this specific tub a plastic one, but a partly mineral composite, which is a highly interesting fact to bring later on during a boring conversation. Some people will want to reuse the outer tub as a stock tank for a donkey or a small child, or as a frivolous planter, but I will not, since it looks ugly and has many holes to take care of to make it completely watertight. If you want it, you will find that one in the trash in front of my hacienda. Next, we also have some heavy concrete counterweights that prevent the washing machine from bouncing around. Only handy in my mind if you are looking for extra weights during a delicate glue up, or to make a body permanently disappear at the bottom of a lake. For me, it will stand in the recycle bin right beside the outer tub. Last in my not so useful collection, we have the door boot seal. This big rubber seal that connects the outer tub to the front door. With its vague birth control for mammoth look, I can't really say it appeals to my mind, but I will happily turn it into a convenient key ring. Starting with the glass door, that one can be used as a simple bowl for fruits or vegetables, or as a porthole style window if the boat lifestyle and the smell of sardines make you happy. We also have many metal parts, like big metal parts that made up the frame of the washing machine. Those could come in handy to repair a broken truck panel, or make an out-of-the-box whiteboard. Other metal parts include the pulley and its driving belt, for a steampunk lamp, or a homemade bandsaw. The springs and shock absorbers for all your springing and shock absorbing fantasies. And the small hardware, including bolts, nuts, screws, pipe clips, big Torx hinges, leveling legs, and two door boot seal clamps for your wildest projects. Pretty neat and easy to reuse. We also have now the inner tub, or in a drum, or in a basin, typically made of stainless steel or enameling iron with porcelain coating. It just looks great on its own, almost like a retro Russian satellite experiment first generation. Reuse applications range from barbecue, to fire pit, to incinerator, to patio heater, to laundry basket, but I will definitely try to reuse it into some sort of design of furniture. You want to know why? Because I can. Moving on, it came directly attached to the inner drum. We have what we professionals call a spider. Because it obviously looks just like one. This is a beefy piece of cast iron that can be reused with the washing machine original bearings to make any big rotating construction. So think of this as a basis for a wind turbine, an incredible fidget spinner, or a carousel for your A-Team action figures. Finally, we have the goodies. The real good stuff that could excite an old bearded guy with the same intensity and amazement than a 5-year-old in front of a midget pony dressed up as Spider-Man. Starting from the top. Ladies and gentlemen, the brain behind the machine, the programmer or PCB. I will not do anything with it since it is toasted. But if you insist, I will consider making a tech-savvy crew chain. Moving on, we have the solenoid water inlet valves, so, some pretty sweet valves that allows to turn water on or off remotely via electric signaling, which can be handy for any garden watering or Chinese torture projects. Next, we have the interference suppression filter, which as its name mentions, does a lot of good stuff for the quality of our electricity, and for the community in general. We have the door lock, that you can use to remotely lock up stuff, like the bedroom window of your 16 years old daughter for instance, if you do not want to have to use the washing machine top cover to collect bodily fluids as previously mentioned. We have the single level pressure switch that measures and reacts to water level, and could be combined with an alarm to inform us that global warming was actually not a social experiment gone wrong, and that building an arch was probably a better plan than stocking up canned enchilada sauce. We have the drain water pump and its little filter friend. If you marry the pump to those hoses we have seen before, oh boy, you could really be pumping all day long, without breaking a sweat. We have the 2000 watt heating element and its little temperature sensor friend, so for reuse in all those projects where heat and sensing are a must, just like during a chili eating contest. And we finally have the crown jewel, the washing machine motor, typically operating in the 400 RPM range for washing, and 11,500 RPM range during spinning cycle, that can be adapted for use in the workshop, possibly as a driving motor for a lathe, a belt or disc sander, but more likely as a dust collecting weight somewhere at the back of a shelf. This said, if we add up all the components on the wire, this is almost $200 of good working components that have been salvaged from this broken washing machine, so pretty good stuff for the ones, like myself, who likes to reuse old stuff. So folks, if you have a broken washing machine at home, and did not know what to do with it, you now have it, feel free to send it over here. 'Cause I need more of those tech-savvy crew chains.